In this video, you're going to learn how to solve and graph compound inequalities. We're going to go through four examples together, and we're going to talk about how to work with these. So first of all, what exactly is a compound inequality? Well, it's two inequalities that are basically put together with the word and or. And what and means, it means it's like the intersection or the overlap of the two solutions of the two inequalities. Whereas or represents like the union, meaning it's like a combination of both of those solution sets. So we're gonna see how this works in these four examples. The first example we have is an or type. 3x plus 5 is less than 2, or 2x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 5. And just a reminder, when you look at these inequality symbols, it's just like when you read a sentence from left to right. When you look at the symbol, it kind of looks like the letter L for less than. The other way to think about it is it points to the smaller quantity and it is like an alligator, like going after the larger quantity. So you can see 3x plus 5 is smaller or less than 2. And of course, this is going to be greater than or equal to. So this is kind of like half of an equal sign. So when you go ahead and solve these, it's just like solving an equation. You want to get the variables on one side, numbers on the other side. So we're going to subtract 5 from both sides. So now we have 3x is less than negative 3, and we're going to divide both sides by 3 to get x by itself. So now we have x is less than negative 1. And then over here, we're going to try to get this variable by itself. So first we're going to add 1 to both sides. So we have 2x is greater than or equal to 6, and then we're going to divide both sides by 2. And we can see that x is greater than or equal to 3. Now, one thing you want to be careful of when you're solving inequalities is that if you multiply or divide by a negative number, what happens is the inequality sign is going to flip or change direction. So just if you yourself multiply or divide both sides by a negative number. Now notice this is an or. So what we can do is we can go to our number line and we can say x is less than negative 1. So what does that mean, less than negative 1? Well, it doesn't include negative 1. So we're going to draw this as an open circle, like hollow. Less than means it includes the points here that are less than or lower or smaller than negative 1. And as we go to the left, the numbers are getting smaller, right? Whereas the second inequality, let's go over to 0, 1, 2, 3. X is greater than or equal to 3. So equal to 3 or greater, as we go to the right, the numbers are getting larger. And then when you see that word or, that means union. It means it's all of these values as well as all these values. So it's like the combination of the total here. So it's basically everything that we have graphed. So this is the solution to the first example. Let's take a look at the next example. Okay, let's look at number 2 now. We've got negative 12 is less than 5x plus 3 is less than or equal to 23. So this particular one is different than the first example. The first example was an or. This one is an implied and. And what does that mean? Well, you can see what we have here is we have actually two inequalities that are put together. We have this one, which let's write it over here separately. Negative 12 is less than 5x plus 3. And here's our implied and. We have this inequality on the right side. We have 5x plus 3 is less than or equal to 23. So one way to do this is to split it apart into two inequalities and solve them separately. So let's go ahead and do that. So what we're going to do is think about getting the variables on one side, numbers on the other. So I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides of the inequality. And we want to solve for x. I'm going to divide both sides by 5. Okay. And so now we have negative 3 is less than x, or you could say x is greater than negative 3. I just flipped that inequality over. For the second one, we're going to get the numbers on one side, variables on the other. So we have 5x is less than or equal to 20. Divide both sides by 5 to get x by itself. So we have x is less than or equal to 4. And keep in mind that this is an and. So our solution is x is greater than negative 3 and x is less than or equal to 4. Now graphically, what this looks like on the number line, negative 3 is over here, 0 is somewhere over here, 4 is somewhere over here. I'm going to go from low to high. So what we have is x is greater than negative 3. So greater than we're graphing to the right, it's getting larger. And at the same time, x is less than or equal to, so equal to is a closed circle, less than means we're going to the left or smaller, but the and means the overlap or the intersection of the two sets. It's what they have in common. So you can see they're overlapping right here, okay, up to that point. So our final result, our answer here that we can graph on the number line is going to be from negative 3 to 4, including 4. And what we can do with these two inequalities, we can put them back together as like one inequality. And the way that I would do that is, you see here how we have x is greater than negative 3 or negative 3 is less than x. So let's write that down. Negative 3 is less than x. And at the same time, x is less than or equal to 4. And so you can see x is in between, see, negative 3 and 4, not including negative 3, but including positive 4. It's like x is sandwiched in between. And you can still see we have those two inequalities here. We have x is greater than negative 3, and we have x is less than or equal to 4. It's just so we put them together as like one inequality. The one thing you want to be careful of when you put these together, you always want these inequality signs to be pointing to the left. So they could be less than or equal to. You always want that variable in the middle. And you're going to find that the smaller number here is on the left, and the larger number is here on the right, and the variable is like in between that smaller and greater number. Now, if you have a situation where they're pointed like this, you can flip this whole inequality so that it's in this proper form. Let's take a look at another example. For number 3, we've got 2x minus 7 is less than 4x plus 3, or 1 half x plus 4 is greater than or equal to 8. So how would we solve that one? Well, when it's an or, we can just solve these individually. And then remember, or means union, so it's like we're going to look at the combination of the two solution sets. So when we do this, we want to get the variables on one side, numbers on the other, just like solving an equation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add 7 to both sides. Okay, so that gives us 2x is less than 4x plus 10. Then I'm going to get the variables on the other side, so I'm going to subtract 4x from both sides. So that gives us negative 2x is less than 10. And then I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2 to get x by itself. Now remember, when you multiply or divide both sides by a negative, the inequality sign changes direction. So this is going to be x is greater than negative 5. Now for the other inequality, we're going to get the variables on one side, numbers on the other. So we have 1 half x is greater than or equal to 4. Let's multiply both sides by 2, because 1 half times 2 is 1. That'll give us the variable by itself. X is greater than or equal to 8. Okay, so we have, let's go to the number line now. We've got these two inequalities. We have negative 5, so x is greater than negative 5, so that means to the right of negative 5, 0 somewhere over here, 8 somewhere over here, or x is greater than or equal to 8. Now, or means union. So we're basically taking all of these numbers, like negative 5, negative 4.5, negative 4, all these numbers here, as well as all these numbers here. So we're like combining these together. It's the union. Union means like you're uniting the two sets. So our final result is going to be this right here on our number line. And our answer is just going to be x is greater than negative 5. Now, if this was an and problem, and means the intersection, we'd say, oh, where are they overlapping? They're only overlapping from 8 or to the right, so x is greater than or equal to 8. But with or, we're talking about union, we actually combine these together into one, and that answer here is graphed on the number line, x is greater than negative 5. Let's take a look at another example. Okay, before we do this last number 4 and type of problem, if you like the way that I explain things and you want to go deeper into Algebra 1 or Algebra 2 with me, check out my video courses for sale. I'll put a link in the description below. And I take you through 85 lessons in the one course, 87 lessons in the other course. We go through the concepts, we go through example problems. I give you some problems that you can practice on your own, and we'll go through those together as well. And I take you step by step, building on the previous concepts to help you walk through both Algebra 1 or the Algebra 2 / College Algebra course. So check those out if you're studying that. And let's dive into this last example together. So You can see that this is an AND type. And in the first example, we broke them apart into two separate inequalities, and then at the very end, we put them back together. Remember that? But there's another way to do this, and that's to get the variable by itself in the middle, and it's like solving the two inequalities at the same time, like simultaneously. So what I mean by that is we're trying to get this x by itself, so instead of subtracting 2, let's add 2 to the left, to the right, and to the middle. And so if we do that, you can see we're getting negative 6 is less than negative 1/3 x is less than or equal to negative 3. Now here we want to get our x, our variable by itself in the middle. So the negative 1/3 times x, we could divide by negative 1/3 or multiply everything by negative 3. So let's go ahead and multiply by the reciprocal, negative 3. That's going to give us 18 here. That's going to give us 9 here. That's going to give us x here. But remember, when you multiply or divide both sides of an inequality by a negative number, that inequality sign is going to change direction. So that's going to make this a greater than or equal to. That's going to make this a greater than. But remember that little caveat we talked about earlier? You really want these inequality signs to be pointing to the left. You want them to be less than or equal to signs. So what I have to do is pick up this whole inequality and flip it. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take it, flip it over. This is going to become 9 is here, 18 is here. When I flip it, this is going to be a less than or equal to, and this is going to be a less than. Now it's going to be a little bit easier to graph. We can go on our number line. We can say here's 9, here's 18, and x is sandwiched in between 9 and 18. It's actually greater than or equal to 9. See, greater than or equal to 9. And at the same time, it's less than or smaller than 18. So it's in between 9 and 18. It includes 9, but it doesn't include 18. So this is, you know, your solution. This is like a graph of our solution. And remember, this includes not just integer values, but fractions and decimals and basically everything in between these two points. So great job if you're able to follow this video. If you want more practice, I'll put another video right there. Follow me over to that video and we'll get some more practice. I'll see you there.